Hi there, my name is Robert from tmile.com, and today I would like to present a step-by-step screencast on how to download and install WordPress manually. You can do that for testing themes or plugins locally on your PC before uploading them to your live website. But that's not the case in this video. Hosting providers like SiteGround or Bluehost are offering one-click install for this fantastic content management system. So make sure you check out the links in the description box where you can get an available discount at this time for hosting services. When you buy hosting through those links, we will get a commission, and that will keep us happy and inspired to produce new and helpful content. Even though you can automate the entire process, you can still download WordPress and then install it manually on any web server. You can do that by using FTP software or by simply uploading the files to the file manager offered within the cPanel. So, I invite you to stay with me for the next 10 minutes in which I will show you exactly how to download and install WordPress through FTP step by step. First, I will download WordPress from their official website, which is wordpress.org, and then I will extract the files in the same folder. These files are all you need to run a WordPress website on your domain name. Uploading them to your server is as simple as moving files through different folders. Access your web server through FTP file manager like FileZilla, and then go to public HTML to open the folder that will contain your website files. Select all the files excepting the zip file on the left, and then drag them to the right, like so. Depending on how fast your connection is, the transfer can take a while. Once the process is finished, you can type in the web address of your site in the browser to start installing WordPress. One more thing you need to do manually before moving to the next step is to create a database for your WordPress website. To do that, go to the MySQL Databases Manager within the cPanel. Type in a name over here, then click Create Database. Keep in mind this name, including the first word precisely as it is, because you will need it later. To access the cPanel of your web server, usually you need to navigate to www.domain.com/cPanel, where domain will be replaced by your own. Now, you are ready to go to the next step, which is to install WordPress. So, as I already mentioned, navigate to your website using the Chrome browser, for example. Hit Enter, then you should see the language selector of WordPress. If not, and you see errors like 404 not found, or this site can't be reached, your site may be too new. You need to wait a couple of hours to get your domain and web server connected. Reload the page, and when you finally see this window, select your preferred language in the list, then click on Continue. Keep in mind that you need some information like the database name, username, password, and database host to complete the installation. Next, click Let's Go over here, and you will see the screen where you need to enter all these details. Make sure you type in everything correctly, and then click on Submit. WordPress can now communicate with your database, and you can click on Run the installation. Fill in the information below, and you'll be on your way to using the most extendable and powerful personal publishing platform in the world. Click Install WordPress whenever you are ready, and then you can use your login details for accessing the dashboard. Here we are in the backend of our WordPress website, the dashboard, where you can manage everything like posts, media, pages, comments, appearance, plugins, users, tools, and general settings. Do you want me to make a video on how to use all these options of WordPress step by step? Leave your comment below and you will get them answered as soon as possible. I do reply to every comment. Now, let's see how our new WordPress website looks on the front end. To do that, click on Visit Site under your website's name over here. Here is how every new installation of WordPress looks when there is nothing but the default content on it. You can see a post which says, "Welcome to WordPress," and also a sample page. Nothing much, but you can change this fast. First of all, you should search for a theme that will change the look of your website entirely. I would recommend using Neve, which comes with ready-made websites you can import in one click. Whether you are a business owner, a freelancer, or a blogger, pick your preferred demo and then click on Import. The importing process will put together some text and images, and when everything is ready, you can see how it looks live. These blog posts are for demo purpose, and you can edit the title, text, and images like so. You can delete them as well, and then write new posts from scratch. If I reload the homepage right now, you can see that the look of your site is changed, and it's replaced by the pre-built content you saw earlier. Now you can start customizing it with your preferred page builder, which could be Elementor, for example. Just click on Edit with Elementor above, and then you will see the live editor of Elementor. You can change the text here. The image you see in the background, like so, and also the color of your writing. See more about how to use Neve and Elementor to make a website from scratch in the recommended video above. I put some links in the description box below, so you can check out later how to recreate popular sites. If you have questions about how to use WordPress, themes, plugins, or you want me to record videos for specific things about WordPress, leave a comment below and I will do my best to answer your request. I do read and answer each comment. If you are new here, make sure you hit the subscribe button, then ring the bell to get notified when we publish a new video. Until then, you can check other video tutorials on our channel. I'm sure you will find something interesting. See you in the next video. Cheers!